put a remote control back together again?
Can you tie a knot in a cherry stem?
Yes. But not in my mouth.
I can do it for you in your mouth.
Hey, welcome to the 15-4 challenge. It's about 7 o'clock.
And I'm doing shoulder rolls.
And she's doing shoulder rolls. Hey, Mike. How are you? I haven't heard from you in God knows how long. That's Mike Cerrone. We're going to go ahead and warm up a little bit. We enjoyed playing the hand pan and the Doumbek yesterday so much that we figured we'd open up with that. In actuality, we've been sitting here since yesterday when we stopped. And
we've just been waiting for you guys to come back for the whole time.
Changed our shirts and we're ready to pick up where we left off. It's like we're always just here. Ready?
Sure.
Ready to restart last time.
Okay, bye.
So since we veered off a little bit in the beginning.
Where's my doom step? My doom step has gone astray.
Reach for it.
Got it.
You're never gonna push that through this.
Don't you ever leave home again. I was so worried.
You were.
No. It's just a piece of wood.
That's right. Bloods.
Your mom floats. Very kind of on the top of the water. Sorry.
So why don't we'll go through some of the rhythms, because I think at this stage, before we get too far ahead, you need to be able to associate names with rhythms and variations.
That's a good idea, because when Jesse goes, seaweed, do you want to play Saidi? I should know what he's talking about.
That's right. She should say, big Saidi or little Saidi?
See? I should have known to say that. Look, I found a duck.
You found a duck. Is that a duck on your drum, or you're just going to play it well? So let's start with Balladi. That's our one that everybody...
I know that one.
Okay, how does Balladi go?
It goes...
Right. Now, there's a... There's a
wait,
much...
is that right? Doom. Okay, yeah.
Personal favorite of the whole Jones family. So if any of the Joneses actually watch this, they always play Balladi. But there are
they don't variations. Just always play Balladi. That's a lie.
There are other variations of Balladi too. Like that one that we play there, that we think is the most familiar, is actually a much closed version of Balladi. There's an open version of Balladi too, which goes. You to drop strokes and be able to still be playing the rhythm.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And in a lot of the Middle Eastern rhythms, it's all about, to coin a phrase, it's all about that bass, okay? So if you follow the...
We don't need no treble.
Anything else in there are just accents, because Balladi really is... You know, two, maybe three variations of a rhythm, but anything above that really becomes just fill at that point in time, because you usually just take something like that and throw it at the end, kind of like, you know how we do the...
Yes.
I mean, technically that's a variation.
I do
but,
it on the djembe, but not on this.
It's not on this.
Not on this.
You mean the that?
I can't rule on it yet.
Well, that's fine, but. Like I said, you know, people can get carried away with variations because there's so many variations. Because you literally anything you do differently, but as long as you keep that bass pattern, it's still
right.
Technically in the Balladi family.
Right.
But if you were to keep just a... So we would start off with the open version, then the next cycle we play the regular version that we're familiar with.
Okay.
So we go. Away. Like if you're playing in a very loud environment with lots of other drums and instruments, you don't necessarily have to put as many notes in there because you're just really keeping the bass at that time. So you could be doing like... The thing about rolls is odd numbers always end on the head that started from.
So what?
Odd numbered rolls always end on the head it started from. And even numbers always end on the opposite end.
I don't know how many I'm doing.
Huh?
I don't know how many I'm doing.
It's hard to count when you're going that bad. Well, there you are. But you can't make it past four. Because it takes too much to say five. Alright, so and now let's go to another rhythm like Maksum. Now Maksum open, we're familiar with, is the and you can do this with a tech work. Maksum, which is the one that goes. There's stability there? But that's how these rhythms are, can be so easily layered on top of each other. But in addition to that Maksum, there's another variation of Maksum, which is something that you'll probably have heard in the drum circle, which goes... She plays, I just play it a little differently.
This is Maksum we're doing right now?
Yes, this is Maksum. It goes. This is a little bit easier hand technique than she plays.
What? What is that?
So it's. Doom, ka, tek, ka, doom, ka, tek, ka, doom, ka, right there.
We didn't go over them for long enough for me to remember.
That's fine. Well, why don't we do this? Why
don't I think we should just focus on one rhythm.
Right. Which one? Maksum or Balladry? Let's do
I one. Already know Balladry.
Oh, let's do Maksum.
No, let's do Balladry. Just because it's fun.
We'll see right here. Well, the variations.
We're doing it. We're doing it in Melissa Jones's honor.
The variations that we'll do is we'll do the open version of Balladry. Then the closed version of Balladry.
How about we just play?
But you gotta switch back and forth. Yeah, just linger, not too long.
Fine.
Yeah, what are you thinking then?
Do you have to let it linger? You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your Doumbek. Do you have to let it contact? That's not validated.
That's not
validated. I don't remember.
remember how to do the open version.
You're just dropping that ka in the middle.
Well, it was just so much fun to do it.
Tech,
you just said it was ka tech.
The last?
You said it was ka tech.
It's tech ka and then ka tech.
Tech ka, ka tech.
Practicing the malfoof, which was the but it's the upbeat where Django is da 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 da. Malfoof
is that how that goes?
Yeah, it's different. This is different than one's an upbeat.
But
it's still the same time signature.
It's the same thing.
It's the same time signature, but one's an upbeat and one's a straightforward.
That's fun to do too.
That's like a Ghidra.
A what?
Ghidra, when the dancers dance, they get the evil off of them, they flick the...
Why do they have evil on them? Have they been swimming in black
time? Why does anybody have evil on them? But it's a very sacred dance. So let's go ahead and do a little jam. How about that?
How about we just do a little jam?
A little jam.
Right? I don't know.
Thank you. Well, we hope you enjoyed our 15-4 challenge today. Practice doesn't always have to be about the book. Sometimes it can be just playing, because I mean, you're doing this to enjoy it. You know, you're not just doing this to learn something. You should be doing whatever you're learning to enjoy.
You should have known I was going to do that. This kind of person I am.
So we are hoping that you're doing something and learning something and enjoying this, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
See ya.